I'm Wes Dirksen, and our relationship before we chose to follow Jesus was a lot of rules and not a lot of Jesus, not necessarily a personal relationship, and not fulfilling either. I guess we were always searching for something else out there.
I'm Crystal Dirksen. I would say our relationship with Jesus was, like I said, very traditional. We weren't really seeing our relationship with Jesus grow.
Yeah, I agree. We didn't see God work because we didn't really believe the promises he had for us or for everyone. And we didn't really believe what the Bible said.
Or like the power of God. We didn't really, our eyes weren't open to see it, like as true miracles for what Jesus is capable of doing. When my eyes were really opened, was the first time I went to Haiti. Just having the miracles happen right before us that I'd never seen before. And not saying that Jesus didn't have miracles happen in our life. I know that he has. We've had many miracles in our lives, but we didn't see it for really what it was. And came back home from that mission trip, and I think we were looking back really blessed because I think God was working in both of our hearts at the same time. Just the fact that we both could leave together was truly incredible.
I agree. That's a miracle in and of itself, that it happened at the same time. And part of that was the only reason Crystal went on that mission trip was because she had miscarried at that point. So looking back, it was definitely God. God working through a crappy situation, but using it in a wild way, a miraculous way. Before we had Jesus in our life, we kind of just muddled through best way possible without any hope or any really reasoning behind it.
Yeah, I'd say through like the hard times, we mostly would get angry at God. Like, we didn't really have that trust or faith. And then as we started, our faith started growing. We had that faith and trust, and we could rely on Jesus in giving us just that comfort. And I would say, life isn't easy. It's never going to be easy. But with Jesus, there's that hope that you can fall back on.
Nice metals teacher when I was in high school, 17 years ago now, had took us senior boys to a prison study. And I think he more did it just to scare us straight because he took us through the general population area. So that always stuck in the back of my head, but I definitely was not following Jesus after high school, so it was just kind of back there. And then once we were starting to a little bit question what was really out there for Christianity and being challenged to serve, and we were looking for ways to serve. Mm-hmm. Looked up that old teacher, and he took us under his wing and got us in there. And
Wes, like, right away called him up and said, we are going to join you, and we need to get this done. And we did our training and started going. And, yeah, it was wild. It was definitely out of our comfort zone. And just seeing the inmates that take what they firmly believe and make the best of it and try to be an example every day in their cells, in their daily routine, and just be joyful and try to have other inmates see that joy. It's pretty incredible.
Anything you put in serving will be returned to you tenfold. And I think we're realizing that when you get out of our comfort zone and serve, I know we've heard it here at church, but you do get to see a firsthand seat to what God is doing and to be blown away by what God is doing, and you can't get that high anywhere else. We ended up at RCC because of, we heard about it through three different people. You tell about how the time changed, so we slept, overslept, and had to make it to church.
Well, that was the third time.
No, well...
You heard it first through your trucking buddy.
My interest was sparked in RCC by one of my friends who was giving a Bible by one of his trucking buddies. And I was wondering why someone that I used to party with 10 years ago was now handing out Bibles.
And then we ran into our son's speech teacher at the grocery store, and she said that she had been coming to RCC for a couple months. And then I think the following Sunday we overslept with the time change and missed two different church services. So we came to the 11 o'clock here at RCC, and we sat in the very back, and Barry was preaching that day, and just hearing his faith story, hearing his trust in God with loss, and it was incredible. I think we both sobbed like babies that whole day service, but we knew that this was a good fit for us. I'd say our lives have changed in the fact that we just try to be happy, be joyful, trust in God. Prayer is powerful. Pray more often throughout the day. I find myself praying a lot. If someone's struggling with God or struggling with life, I guess the thing that for myself I found out, God has a sense of humor. Like, there's no sense trying to hide anything from Him. Pour your heart out to Him. Trust in Him.
God has a plan, and you may not understand the plan till a couple years later, but it will blow you away once you see it. And the other thing is, once you do start praying and asking God to work in your life, don't be surprised when He does, and don't be surprised when He takes you on ways and paths you never imagined.